Hello, National ACDA. My name's John Stafford. I'm Associate Professor of Choral Music and Vocal Jazz at Kansas City, Kansas Community College. And I'm also the National Repertoire Resources Chair for Vocal Jazz for the American Choral Directors Association. This is your virtual vocal jazz reading session. I'm just doing a recording here, and I'm going to share my screen with all the great music that we have. I picked a variety of music that comes from different publishers, but mostly my selections had to do with showing a different arranger for almost every tune that I have right now for this reading session. So there's going to be some new arrangers that you don't know about, and some of the more popular arrangers in the field of vocal jazz. So let's get started. I have about 13 or 14 pieces for you, so we're gonna get started, and here we go. The first set of pieces that I'm gonna present to you will be from the Carrie Marsh catalog. Check out carriemarsh.com. Carrie's, he now teaches at the University of Kansas starting this year, and teaching their vocal jazz ensemble and starting to build that program up again. And Carrie has a wonderful catalog of probably 200 to 300 charts. And him and his wife, Julia Dullison, they create great demo recordings, sing on all the demos and everything. And so you know what the chart sounds like before you buy it from beginning to end. And it's a variety. He has a variety of levels on his website, like a starter series for beginning groups, and quite a bit of music for advanced ensembles as well. And all he has stuff in all voicings, different arrangers that he promotes. He writes a lot of the arrangements, but I know his wife writes arrangements. And several other people. He has several arrangers in his catalog, so it's great stuff. Really check out his site. We're gonna do about 4 pieces that are in that catalog right now to start off this reading session. So here we go. I'm gonna share my screen with you all. The first piece I'm gonna share with you is by a colleague of mine. One of my good friends and my colleague at KCKCC, Dr. Justin Benick. Justin is a wonderful musician, jack of all trades. He's a teaches theory at our college, but he's a professional jazz vocalist and pianist. And Justin and I actually were fortunate enough to work with Mid-America Concert Productions in New York this past June to perform this work, his Miso Lucis, his Mass of Light. We performed the whole work in Carnegie Hall with an 80-person choir and a jazz quintet, all from Kansas City. And we performed it with 2 of the New York voices, Peter Elridge and Lauren Kennan. And then it was very exciting performance. And I like to share with you some stuff about the work. What I'm gonna do is share just things about the work, and then I'll play the work with the score for you. Let's see, this work is for SATB choir with a jazz rhythm section. You could do it with just piano only. You could do it with guitar, bass, drums. There are even horn parts for this available. You could use up to about 5 or 6 horns if you had that capability. So you could have a good size, a large jazz combo perform this as well. This work is great for vocal jazz ensembles and for choir. Another thing about this reading session is that there are several of these pieces that I'm presenting will work for your choir. And so if you're just now getting into vocal jazz, or if you want to add some diversity to your set, to add a jazz type work, some of these works work well for a larger choir. And then some of these works really work well for the traditional vocal jazz ensemble. Let's see here. The improv section is flexible, meaning that There's room, you can add as much of the improv section in terms of repeats as you want, or you could take a lot of the improv sections out if you don't have musicians that are comfortable with doing improv. And that's really it for this work. The work is in 6 movements total, but I'm sharing this movement, the Gloria from that mass, because I think it's the earworm, it's the catchiest tune. And just like I said, this is accessible for all types of groups, high school, college, community choirs, church choirs. So check it out. I'm gonna play the recording and then I'm gonna switch and scroll so you can see the score and everything. So I'll play it from beginning to end. Most of the tunes I play today will be from beginning to end. There's a few tunes that I'll only play a portion of just because of time, but I'll play this one from beginning to end. So here we go. Let me get my volume up. All right.
Jesus.
All right. So like I said, wonderful work. That was Justin singing in that recording. Shows you how great a musician he is. And then hope you enjoyed that. We'll just keep this going. The next work that we're gonna do, I'm gonna switch over to here. The next work we're gonna do is a work by Carrie Marsh. Well, it comes from Carrie Marsh, but his wife Julia wrote it. And the work is called Satellite, commissioned by Galvane Williams and Sacramento State Vocal Jazz Ensemble. That's a wonderful program. And then, so the music is from this new up and coming popular songwriter. If I mispronounce her name, I'm sorry. Lalita Bali. And she writes some great music that several vocal jazz arrangers are using right now. She gives the rights to her music for a good price. And so there's a lot of arrangers right now using her songs to turn into vocal jazz charts. Let's see, I know Julia wrote this, and then Matt Falker, he's used some of her music as well to write some vocal jazz charts from. This work in particular, I did it with my vocal jazz group last year. It's a nice catchy tune. It's just a really good songwriting technique, first of all, so it's a great chart. This is an advanced group that an advanced high school or collegiate ensemble would perform this work. This is SSATB. Just FYI, a lot of the music I'm doing, a lot of it's SATB, a lot of the stuff I'm showing. There's a few treble pieces and there's a few SAB pieces that I'll be presenting later. My goal was, I was trying to do different voicings that you could find, but the bigger goal was to try to feature some arrangers that you probably don't see as often in vocal jazz. So I was just trying to really mix everything up. Anyway, in terms of this tune, the reason it's an advanced tune, there's a couple reasons. One, it's quite chromatic later on in certain sections. So there's some moments of a lot of chromaticism happening, very colorful writing from Julia. And then also too, later on in the chart, it splits into like a lot of different layers. So there's a lot of polyrhythmic layering happening in the chart. So where like it could be five or six different rhythmic layers at a time near the climactic part of the chart. So just FYI, it's a great tune though. Your students will love it. And so here we go. So here's Satellite.
Drive to your satellite. signal me. It cuts across the galaxy, and it goes adi 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 adi. Guess there's a long way home to you.
Like I said, great tune. It's really happening stuff. One thing about teaching vocal jazz is that if you really want to get students one way to really get students into vocal jazz is that students are used to listening to blues and any folk or popular music. And then if you give them an arrangement that's in that style, with jazz harmony, that's a great way to get students into vocal jazz. So once you get them hooked with that, or at least get introduced a tune like that, then sometimes it's actually easier to introduce the swing feel later on. Sometimes if you just jump right into the swing feel, this is the experience that I had, and I think it depends where you're from. If you're just starting off a vocal jazz group, it's great to get into swing, and that's important stuff to teach. But the swing stuff is not always in the student's ear if they're new to vocal jazz, but like popular music and blues and anything that's associated with the blues, it's really in their ear already because that's what they've grew up listening to. So just something to keep in mind. So as you create your repertoire, whether you're adding a jazz work to a traditional choir or have a vocal jazz group, diversifying your repertoire will really keep students' interest. Like a course do swing and like in different Latin grooves, but also doing like funk and like some of these arrangements that I'm presenting today, there are more singer-songwriter type arrangements in a vocal jazz setting. I think that's an important thing when it comes to your programming, just really diversifying your programming. So just something to keep in mind. So as we get out of that, I'm gonna go to the next Carrie Marsh chart. This chart was not written by Carrie, but actually none of the charts from his catalog aren't really written by him, even though much of his catalog is by him. But I'm playing different arrangers from his catalog. This arranger, the arranger of this chart, Orange and Blue, David Von Kampen, Dr. David Von Kampen, who teaches great vocal jazz group, the UNL jazz singers from University of Nebraska, Lincoln. Wonderful ensemble. And they actually made it during the COVID year, they actually made a great virtual recording of this chart by Sarah Giros. He's arranged several of her charts, and she's a singer-songwriter, a well-known singer-songwriter as well. It's a beautiful chart. And it's good for probably like beginning college level or even intermediate high school could do this chart, Orange and Blue. David's writing is always harmonically rich, regardless of how many voices he used. This chart in particular is SATB, as you can see. And it's a great tune, especially for teaching unison, because the verses have the treble voices in unison, and then the lower voices in unison in the second verse. So this is a great chart for that, to learn how to sing unison and split into harmonic parts in the chorus. So check out Orange and Blue. Here we go.
Shadow of the cypress tree, I stumbled in its tangled roots, surrounded by the tree's forgotten leaves. My knees were bloodied, hands were bruised, while I was down upon the muddy ground, I dug my hands into the earth. I think I found it now, and nothing else will do. A heart that burns so true, burning orange and blue. By this fever dream, I kept digging underground, trying to figure out just what it means to find a thing that can't be found. I think I found it now, and nothing else will do. Still kneeling by the water's edge, the sky is black and thunder rolls, but now I hold this heart within my hands.
so true. Burning orange and blue.
There. Like I said, another great chart. I'm going to stop my share for a minute. I am here, just turn my video back on, and then I'm going to share again. And then in all of the Carrie Marsh catalog, it's him and Julia singing all the parts. They are such exceptional musicians to write all this stuff and record it all for their patrons. So it's really a great service that they do for the field of vocal jazz. It's a wonderful service. So I just wanted to give them a shout out for that. And then let's see here. There is another tune that I like to share with you, which I am looking for right now. One more tune from the Carrie Marsh catalog, which I'm looking for. Just give me 1 second. And hold on 1 second. There we go. All right. So this new tune from the Carrie Marsh catalog, this is the last one that we'll do for this reading session here. This is a Peter Elridge tune, and he recorded it by the art with the artist Becca Stevens. They have a great recording online of this tune, "Wish You With Me," and in this tune in particular, it's actually written for SAB ensemble, and it's written for SSATB vocal jazz ensemble. This is a great tune that you could do with choir. And it's a good tune to introduce students to this type of harmony, some real colorful moments. It's a tune where everything's very chordal. Everybody's singing the same syllables at the same time. So it's a great tune to work on vowels and things of that nature. And it's working on vowels, lock chords. You could do this with both high school and collegiate groups, or if you have a community group as well, this would be a great tune for that. Let's see. Oh, and also the tune, Peter Elridge recorded a tune on this album, Disappearing Day. So it's a fantastic album. So I highly recommend getting that album. Again, it's called Disappearing Day. And this tune came out about right before COVID, or either around 19 or 20. And so it's a great tune. Check it out. And it's not that long, but it's a lovely ballad. So hope you enjoy.
First, there's sour. And then they're sweet. Sour Patch Kids.
Whoa!
Let me guess. I missed it.
It was perfect, wasn't it?
Well, I'm sorry. This is what happens when you use YouTube. The ads come through. So I'll just leave it. My apologies.
Even through
There you go. So that's some of the music by Carrie Marsh from his catalog. So just wanted to share that stuff with you. Let's go to something totally different. Let's go to a swing tune that you should find in your packets here. If you need a packet, if you signed up for a vocal jazz packet, I will have some packets available when I get out to National ACDA. So again, just look me up. I'll be around the entire week. So just look me up and then we'll get going with that. The next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna show you, we're gonna get to a new arranger. This new arranger that a lot of people probably don't know. It's a friend of mine. Something about myself, I went to Millikan University back in the 90s. And so I studied, I did vocal jazz for a little bit out there with Steve Wiedenhofer and studied choral music with Brad Holmes out there. And it's funny how you go to college and you have a lot of friends that are in the field doing the same thing your professors did. So it's great. And this next arranger, Jeremy Landig, who lives in the Chicago area. Jeremy is a wonderful jazz pianist and arranger and bass singer, and he teaches at Lewis University in a south suburb in Chicago. And Jeremy does also a lot of work with doing show choir writing. He does a lot of show choir arranging. He also does a lot of contemporary a cappella and vocal jazz arranging as well. You could check out his website before I play this recording for you. I'm going to back up here so you can see this. Let's see if I could go back here. And I'll just go back forward in, I guess. So, but his website, I thought if I go back, I could find the website. But his website is landigmusic.com. landigmusic.com. Check this out. He has a lot of arrangements for both that will work well for show choir, contemporary a cappella, and vocal jazz on his site. Jeremy's been around for a while and he's just trying to get more of his music out there. So that's another arranger that's kind of under the radar, but has wonderful material. He's just a solid writer, especially he's especially a good piano, not only a good vocal writer, but a good piano writer. So really look at his music. Let's see here. This chart here, the swing tune, it was written by Tim Buchholz, who teaches at the University of Wisconsin, Stevens Point. He's had a great vocal jazz program in Wisconsin for a long time. He's one of the major people from Wisconsin that do vocal jazz. And this chart's accessible for both high school and collegiate groups. Great chart to teach swing concepts. So if you're teaching swing for the first time, this is a good chart to look at. And I don't think it's too difficult. There's a lot of parts where it splits into, there's a lot of sections where it splits into four or five part harmony, but there's a lot of unison licks in here as well to help teach not only swing feel but like swing phrasing. And so it's a nice chart to look at. We will not look at this whole chart. This is what I have here is the perusal score, and it only goes through half the chart. I'm going to play this recording. There's a recording of this from an Illinois District Vocal Jazz Group from several years ago, and then I'll switch over to the score so you can see it, so you at least get an idea of the tune and everything. So here we go.
Help rebuild acid weakened enamel every time you brush.
YouTube ads, I'm sorry.
So what are you brushing with
tonight's dinner? It's gonna be
this
great.
This is just beyond the recording. Oh well.
I used to know you, baby. I used to know you well.
Stop the recording right there. The guy directing in that recording, that's Dan Gregerman. Dan Gregerman's a great high school vocal jazz instructor, has been for several years. And Dan Gregerman, I want to give a shout out to him because he'll be at National ACDA. And Dan just wrote/organized a new book about rehearsing the vocal jazz ensemble. And in the book, there are 12 different authors. I'm fortunate enough and proud to be one of those 12 different authors of the book. The book really covers all things vocal jazz. Dan asked 12 different vocal jazz directors from different perspectives, from different walks of life. Like, some directors teach graduate jazz programs. Some of them are high school directors. I'm a community college instructor. And just like all different aspects. So, and it's a wonderful text to check out because these are my colleagues in the book. They've all had quite a bit of success teaching vocal jazz, and then they're really active in the field. And we all had, and Dan wanted us to talk about our philosophy of teaching vocal jazz. We all talk about our audition process. We all talk about what we've learned during our years teaching vocal jazz. You're really getting 12 different opinions about what those people think about vocal jazz, how it's important to them, what they want to teach to their students. And so it's really all be all book about the whole vocal jazz experience. And it's published through GIA. Some of the arrangers will be in attendance at the conference. I know Dan will be there. I know Roger Emerson will be there. He was one of the authors. Myself, I'll be there as well. So if you have any questions about the book, please check that out. So I just want to give a shout out to Dan Gregerman. Now we're going to keep going. We're going to do a couple of Hal Leonard charts. And I'm sorry about the YouTube ads. I figure I tried to do the session this way, and so it happens. And then the next tune I want to do for you, actually, these next two tunes, these Hal Leonard tunes, these are tunes that are kind of tribute pieces. This first one, It's from the musical The Music Man, and Till There Was You. So many of us know this song. This is a newer arrangement that was really just published this past summer by Hal Leonard, and it was arranged by Paris Rutherford, who just passed away back in December. And so shout out to Paris Rutherford for all that he did in the field of vocal jazz. He has a ton of great arrangements, all published through Hal Leonard. And then, so please check out his music. Paris Rutherford, if you don't know the name, he started, from what I know of, he started the University of North Texas vocal jazz program, which is now led by Jennifer Barnes. And Paris is just a great arranger, just a solid writer. And so all of this stuff, it's very good for all levels of vocal jazz ensembles. And then this tune is also a SATB chart. And this is a lovely arrangement of Till There Was You. It's a great reharm of the original tune. And it also, as well, in vocal jazz, sometimes you have a lot of descending passages that are quite chromatic. So it's a great tune to teach some tuning, how to tune descending lines, because it has several of those in the song. And so it's a good chart to work on tuning. So I hope you enjoy Till There Was You.
Lindor, made to melt you this Valentine's Day by the Lindt Master Chocolatier.
The best way to burn fat and get shredded is not keto, not paleo, and it's definitely...
Love all around.
So as you can see so far with a lot of tunes that I'm playing, these tunes are very adaptable for not they're not just for vocal jazz. You could do these with your choirs as well. And then that was one of the goals of doing this reading session, to show a variety of arrangers, both some that you know and some that you don't know probably, and to have some of the music be adaptable for a concert choir setting, and just to really just present good music to you. Let's see here. Let's do another tune. This is another tribute by the very well-known Kirby Shaw. And so Kirby Shaw here wrote this newer arrangement of "Send in the Clowns," and by Stephen Sondheim, who passed away about a year or so ago. And so this is a tribute to Stephen. It's a lovely a cappella number by Kirby Shaw, quite different from some of the other stuff that he's done, I think. But it's a fresh new arrangement of this work. It's very accessible for all types of choral ensembles. And especially this will really work. This would be very interesting. This would be a very interesting work to hear with a larger choral ensemble as well. And so it's just a really nice and it's a very rhythmic arrangement, but harmonically it's not as complicated as some other Kirby Shaw tunes. But it's just really good writing and vocal writing, and I think you'll enjoy it.
Isn't it rich?
Hey, are we gonna fit?
At American Family Insurance, we're here to carefully protect your dreams.
All right, open your eyes. Welcome home.
Save up to 23% when you bundle your home and auto insurance today. Get a quote or find an agent at amfam.com.
Are we a pair? Me here at last on the ground, you in midair, sending the clouds. Isn't it bliss? Don't you approve? Who keeps staring around, one who can't move. Where are the clowns? Send in the clowns. Just when I stopped, I stopped opening doors, finally knowing the entrance again with my usual flair, sure of my lines, no one is dead. Don't you love farce? You'd want what I want. Sorry, my dear. But where are the clowns? Quick, send in the clowns. Don't bother, they're isn't it rich? Isn't it queer? Losing my timing this late in my career.
lovely arrangement. That's a really nice tribute work to Stephen Sondheim. And so thank you, Kirby, for writing that arrangement. Let's see here. So we're gonna keep on going. I have more tunes for you. These next tunes I'm gonna present, I'll play, a couple of them are long, so I might not play all of them. But what I want to show you here, I don't have the score for this, but I wanted to show you the website. This website is called, let's just go through the website. This is a new publisher that just came out recently in less than about two years ago, maybe a little less. This is called iJazz Music. It's a place to find all types jazz music for all types of settings. And so they have a big vocal jazz catalog. iJazz stands for International Jazz Music. The board for this publisher is an international board, and that's head by Gene Aiken, who now lives in Thailand. But Gene Aiken years ago used to teach at the University of Northern Colorado. He used to run that vocal jazz program there, which now that program is ran, they've had different directors go through that program. Like they had Kerry Marsh taught there for a while, then Brendan Baglio. And now the director there is Marion Powers that does vocal jazz at that school. They also have a great instrumental program. And then, so Gene runs this program, this publishing site with several other people. One of the people on that board is ACDA member, Christine Guder, who teaches at Cal State Long Beach. And she directs a fabulous vocal jazz program out there. And so I talked to Christine about sharing this publisher with everybody at ACDA. So I'm gonna play three recordings from this publisher just to show you the site, the vocal jazz portion of the site. Since this is a brand new publisher, you can see all of the arrangements that are here. There are more and more people that are publishing through the site. And so they have quite a few arrangements here. And then they're adding stuff to the site. Every few months, they're adding new charts to the site. So please check it out. It's another resource for vocal jazz. This is one of the newer resources for vocal jazz, especially in terms of publishing music. So what we'll do here, we'll back up a little bit. And we're gonna back up to do this Rosanna Eckert chart. Rosanna Eckert, she worked with Paris Rutherford in North Texas. And now she works with Jennifer Barnes. Rosanna is a great vocal artist. She's kind of a jack of all trades as well. She's a great vocal artist, great vocal writer, and a great voice teacher. So she teaches a lot of the voice lessons for vocal jazz majors at the University of North Texas right now. And then we're gonna do play the recording of this great samba chart that she wrote called For Elizabeth. So I'm just gonna sit here and play the recording to it so you can listen. You should have it in your packet if you're listening along with the packet. So check this out. It's a cool chart. I hope you enjoy. Oh, just a few things about the chart too. In terms of the idea of groove, if you want some up-tempo, even though it says medium, it's a medium level, that's very accessible. But if you want some up-tempo stuff, this is a great chart. And Rosanna has a lot of good Latin charts, especially, even though she writes great in every style. Here we go.
Start of a new day in a season of silence, hoping to hear the sound of glory, the invitation of a friend home again, knowing the way.
Chart. Hope you enjoy it. And please read the description. That's why I left this page up, so you could kind of read the description about the chart. One other thing about this chart in particular, there's a SSA version and a SATB version. So just FYI, so you could do this with all kinds of groups. If you go to Rosanna Eckert's website, she's a ranger that really has a lot of treble vocal jazz music that you can find on her website. So check that out. It's I don't have a lot of treble vocal jazz music in this reading session, but she's an arranger that writes quite a bit of treble vocal jazz music. So if you're looking for SSA or SSAA music, go to her website and you'll find several good tunes there. Just FYI. Going on. Let's see, I'm only going to play part of the next two tunes just to save on time. This next tune is a Peter Elridge tune, but the arranger is Greg Jaspers. A lot of people know Greg Jaspers. He teaches Gold Company, and he directs the graduate vocal jazz program at Western Michigan University, has been for several years now. Peter and Greg are great friends, and Peter Elridge, this comes from a different album of his that came out about 18 years ago now, Decorum. And Peter's music is very, Peter is just a great songwriter. I love his music, especially just because I love the way his approach to melodic writing. It's a very, his tunes are very simple that he comes with, but in terms of intervallic content, it's very colorful melodic writing. So I enjoy doing his music. I'm just gonna play about half of this chart just to save on time, but I hope you enjoy it. Call it Dark Out of the Night.
Trying to get the dark out of the night. Oh.
I just wanted to stop that just because it's a longer tune. That's a great chart though. I probably say that's a great chart for every tune, but you know, I just love this stuff. And that's actually, I know a lot of Greg Jasper's music, and that's an arrangement. I haven't heard an arrangement like that from him before, and I love it. It's one of my favorite arrangements of his. And of course he's a great writer. So congrats to him for publishing this chart. And yeah, so I hope you really consider this piece. So for an SATB ensemble, let's do one more from iJazz Music. The Bobby McFerrin tune from the Vocabularies album that came out several years ago. This is a tune by, this is written out by Roger Treese. That Vocabularies album, it was developed with the concept of circle singing, where there's a lot of improvisation along with this type of music. And this is for SATB ensemble as well. This tune's been out for a long time, but it's just now being published with Roger arranging it, but even though it's mostly a Bobby McFerrin tune. And I'm just gonna play like a middle section of it. I had it set up. I think I just moved it on accident. But I think a lot of you will recognize this tune. I'll play a couple minutes of it, Say La Deo. And it's a really cool chart. Not necessarily easy. It's like a lot of polyrhythmic stuff going on. But it's really a great chart to try. Hope you enjoy it.
Just play.
That's just a portion of that chart where they jump off and do some type of circle singing. Read the description. It's a unique chart. Great chart to try to get students to do improvisation without doing the traditional jazz improvisation. They could just do improvisation based on the sonic environment that's around them. So this chart sets up for that. And that's the beauty of doing Bobby McFerrin music. doing circle singing, is to get students to just open up and do things on the fly without having the pressure of knowing what chord change is what and things of that nature. It's really great to just to have students have a sense of freedom. It's just a different way of improvisation. And so this is a very cool chart for that. Please check out iJazz Music. It's a great publisher. The last publisher I'm gonna go to, the last four tunes I'm doing are from Anchor Music Publications. Anchor Music Publications just came about within the last couple years. It's ran by Matt and Jessica Falker, who live in the San Diego area. Matt will be at ACDA. Matt is conducting the ACDA Jazz Immersion Choir, which will perform on Saturday. And so that's very exciting. And Matt will also have a booth for Anchor Music Productions and Publications, sorry, not Productions, Publications, Anchor Music Publications. He'll have a booth at the exhibit, so please check out his booth. It's a very large catalog. Anchor Music Publications used to be Sound Music Publications that was created by Frank DeMiro. And then in the last couple of years, the DeMiro family sold the publishing company to Matt Falker, who rebranded the company, but the entire Sound Music Publication catalog switched over to Anchor Music. So it's a very large catalog. The two largest catalogs in vocal jazz are really Anchor Music Publications and CarrieMarsh.com. And then you'll find smaller catalogs from a lot of different independent arrangers. And well, you have iJazz Music as well, which is a new publisher that's building their catalog. But you'll find a lot of independent arrangers that have good catalogs as well. Jeremy Fox, Michelle Weir, Jennifer Barnes just started a website about a year or so ago, or Rosanna Eckert. Trying to think of other publishers. So those are some of the names that come to mind at this moment. But anyway, just something to check out. Let me play a little bit of these last four tunes. There's five in here. I'm just gonna play four of them. The first one is written by Cedric Dent, who teaches at Middle Tennessee State University, teaches the MTSU Singers. He directs them and teaches theory there as well. He's a former member of Take Six. Him and Matt Falker will be presenting at National ACDA. They'll be doing a gospel slash jazz clinic together at ACDA, which is gonna be awesome. And then let's check out Cedric's work. In terms of this work mixes a lot of different styles together. There are elements of like gospel and hip hop and like funk all within this tune. It has that circle song feel that that's influenced by Bobby McFerrin. It has some gospel licks. It has moments of where the harmony gets quite dense, but most of the harmony is not that, not as difficult, but there's like splashes and like snapshots of some really colorful harmonic moments written for an SATB ensemble. So let's check out from Anchor Music Publications, In the Circle. Well, if I could play it, hold on. Let's refresh it here. Here we go.
Oh, where it ends, oh, let it flow. ba-doom, ba-doom.
Come on. Hey!
Doom, doom, ba-doom.
Hey!
Doom, ba-doom, ba-doom.
Hey!
Doom, doom, ba-doom.
Hey!
Doom, ba-doom, ba-doom.
Hey!
Doom, doom, ba-doom.
Hey!
Doom, ba-doom, ba-doom.
Hey!
Here in the round. The way it goes, it flows, our love, the way it flows, the way it goes, it flows, our love, the way it flows, the way it goes, it flows, our love, the way it flows, the way it goes, it flows, our love, the way
Great tune by Dr. Cedric Dent. I hope you get to meet Cedric at National ACDA. I think he's singing with the Jason Max Fernandet singers as well. So I hope you get to meet him. Just a great gentleman, great, wonderful musician. So, all right, let's keep going. I have three more tunes for you. The next tune was written by, it's actually a Matt Falker arrangement, but the original tune was written by Jamie Hsu, who teaches at Cal State Fullerton. She does vocal jazz out there. This tune is for SAB Ensemble. And it's a great chart for that type of group. It's one of those tunes you could do it one and apart, or you could do it with a larger ensemble. It's just a hip tune. It's hard to find good SAB music, just period. And so, but this is a great hip tune. Uplifting tune that I think would work for an ensemble like that. And the vamp material that's in the tune, there's a lot of catchy stuff happening in this tune. It's kind of an earworm composition called A Place for Me, recently published by Anchor Music Publications. So let's play that.
Sitting in the backyard contemplating life's demands, thinking about all the years gone by, the joys, the pains, the laughs, the cries, the energy of time, constantly wondering how the pieces will combine. I sit there waiting,
I'm waiting,
waiting, waiting for the chance to hear the call, waiting for the chance to understand the meaning of it all. Why do I sit there expecting it to fall? Tired and graying, sense of a wonder fading. Oh, how can this be?
How can it be?
Trying to find a
right there. Such a cool tune. And let's see, such a cool tune. And I think that's probably one of the cooler, I want to say cooler, but I don't know. I'll just say it. I think it's one of the cooler SAB charts that I have seen. Matt really writes well for SAB Ensemble. He has another arrangement I like for SAB Ensemble. He has a great swing arrangement of the classic standard I'm Old Fashioned, which is also published through Anchor. I love that arrangement. I've done that arrangement a few times. So let's go on. Two more charts. This tune, Revelations, is a Carol Wiseman chart, and it's arranged by Eric Hagman, who teaches at Northwest College in Wyoming, Community College in Wyoming, with a historically a great jazz program. This tune right here, let's see, it has nice singable vamp, colorful harmonic structure. The reharm in this chart is, I think, it's fantastic. So kudos to Eric for great vocal writing and harmonic writing in this tune. So let's check that out.
Of the way, it's the dawning of tomorrow, beginning today. It's your light that will guide you along the road, discovering just what treasures await. You must believe in the mystery as it unfolds, and you can fly higher than high. Close your eyes and simply enjoy the ride. Seize the moment, seize like the it's stolen moment. From the story about to be told. Be a dreamer and you'll smile as each dream turns to gold.
Close your eyes and simply enjoy the ride.
Cool. That tune is for SAB, and it's available for SATB ensembles. So, man, that's a hip chart. I love that vamp at the end. I think it's a tune that students could really get into. So hopefully I'm showing you some good SAB material here. This last tune that I'm gonna play for you is written by Aubrey Johnson. It's a New York vocal artist, wonderful artist, and it's a SSAA tune called Unraveled, published by Anchor Music. It's a wonderful chart. It's a very difficult chart. This is an advanced treble ensemble chart. Lots of Debussy going on. It's harmonically colorful. It's not an easy rhythm section chart. It's a chart that you would need a good rhythm section. There's some Debussy within the SSAA setting as well. So just to keep an eye out for that, it uses a huge vocal range. You especially need some low altos to sing some parts, and it's very rhythmic in some places, and it's a lot going on, but it's just a lovely work of art, and hope you enjoy it. And she writes great material, and yeah, I think this is a cool chart to end the reading session with. So here's our last chart, Unraveled.
I'm
Go. All righty here. I'll stop my share there. And then, all right, hope you enjoyed the virtual reading session for ACDA. If you ever have questions about anything vocal jazz, if you need help with any resources or finding repertoire, there's a few places that you could look. So for example, you can always just contact me. I'll give you my email. I work at Kansas City, Kansas Community College. My email is jstafford, J-S-T-A-F-F-O-R-D, at kckcc.edu. And then the other places you could look, I also run the Facebook page, Vocal Jazz R&R for ACDA. The Vocal Jazz ACDA page on Facebook is, I run that. Greg Amron started that page a long time ago, the previous R&R chair, so I took it over. And if you want to find materials about vocal jazz, you can find some stuff on there. I try to update it. I mostly do a lot of work on that page throughout like the summer. That's when I do a lot of the work on the page. In the summer, I try to highlight different composers and arrangers and different school ensembles as well. I'll try to do the same thing this summer, both highlighting new resources and like what ensembles you could check out and listen to. So if you want to advertise your ensemble this summer, that's when I have time to do it. It's difficult during the school year, of course. So but if you have a video or if you have a chart that you want to advertise on Facebook, just hit me up through there and that'd be great. Or you can email it to me as well. A couple other great vocal jazz Facebook pages by Mike Malloy, the vocal jazz educator page. That's a great spot. And also Matt and Jessica Falkard at the beginning of COVID started a vocal jazz educator support page, especially learning how to teach virtually. They started that page and that's still up and running and quite popular as well. So those are like three good Facebook pages to find some vocal jazz information and connect with other vocal jazz performers and educators. And if you have any questions about anything, just find me at the conference. I'll be at all of the jazz events. There's quite a few clinics going on. I'll be at the jazz night concerts. I'll be presiding there. I'll be at the Wednesday, but I'm not the not Wednesday, the jazz night performances are on Wednesday, but on Saturday, Jeremy Fox's group First Take is performing that morning and early afternoon. And then Matt Falker's Jazz Immersion Choir will perform that evening around 5 o'clock on that Saturday. So I'll be around the conference the whole time. If you have any questions about anything jazz, and thank you so much for checking this out. From what I know of, I think there's like roughly 100 people at least checking this out, which is actually more than what it would be in person and past in person. It was less people checking out the vocal jazz reading session material. So they have quite a few people signed up for this. And then packets will be available at the conference. And let me know if you need anything else. So it's a pleasure serving all of you, and hope you have a wonderful day. Take care. Bye-bye.